We'd love to talk right now to Mike Fratello, who calls the game on Yes with Ian Eagle and also with our good buddy Ryan Rucco. Mike, it's Michael Kay and Don LaGreca. How you doing?
Doing great, guys. Thanks for having me on.
Tell me what turned it around for this team, because for a while there, they seemed like they were floundering.
It was a combination of a lot of things. You have to go back to last time they were 500 was 2-2 back in the beginning of November, and then it's been a long struggle back. And there were many people that felt this team was never going to do it, that they would not have the perseverance to take little pieces at a time and build on the little pieces. It wasn't going to be a 12-game winning streak all of a sudden that got them back in it. And to their credit, to Jason Kidd's credit, he never lost the direction that he wanted them heading in. He stayed with it. They went through the injuries, you know, obviously Brooke for the entire season, but the long stretch without Deron Williams, and then a couple of nagging injuries here and there, and Paul Pierce wasn't playing like we know Paul Pierce can play early in the season. Garnett was, is he in, is he out? You know, how much can he contribute? Their training camp was limited as far as the minutes that Jason played those guys, looking ahead to the big picture. So it took a while for all of it to get back together. And there was a stretch where different guys took their turns carrying the team. But here they are now at 29-29. They have three out of the next four games at home. And then down the stretch, basically, they'll be, you know, same number of games on the road as they have at home. And they've got a chance now to really move up here. They're in the sixth place as we're talking to now. Washington is just a game ahead of them. And they beat Chicago, who's in the fourth position right now. And they honestly believe now they have a chance to do a little bit of damage. They've found out how to play small. They basically try to find the best mismatch in their favor. And they've done a very good job eventually creating those mismatches and taking advantage of it and then playing off of it.
Mike, this question comes from a guy that loves Lawrence Frank, and Michael Kay does as well. But this turnaround, does this justify them demoting Lawrence Frank?
Maybe we should look at it that Lawrence Frank has done a hell of a job writing scouting reports and sending him in every night. Because, I mean, he's not taking his position, from what I gather and what I've heard, he's not taking it lightly.
Wouldn't expect him to.
No, that's not who he's about. Mm-hmm. So he treats it with a great amount of respect. He knows what his responsibilities are and what his duties are. And he sends in in-depth reports. And whether they be pre-game reports going into the game or the post-game write-ups after the game, maybe we should look at it that he's done a pretty good job. You know, it's a team thing. Maybe his part that he's doing is has been very good.
Now, Mike, you coached in this league at a high level. I thought at the beginning of the year that Jason Kidd was in over his head. I don't feel that now. I feel that he's gotten his sea legs. Have you noticed that? Do you think he's turned into a pretty good coach?
There's no question he's better now than he was in the beginning, but that's what happens to anyone that, you know, is going to be good eventually. They get better as they go along. They learn from the mistakes they made. They learn from certain experiences. You know, the people that are surrounding him are good basketball people. That's part of, you know, the staff that he put together. And whatever happened with Lawrence, whatever the reasons were, Lawrence is still a contributor. He's just not there on the bench every night contributing. And these other guys have come from programs where they played for other outstanding coaches, and they are helping Jason along the way. But there's times where a guy can listen and make, you know, ultimately make the decision himself at the end. And I think that's where Jason has gotten much better, that perhaps in the beginning he was listening to too many voices. And you can't do that. It gets very confusing when you have three, four different people all with an opinion. That's why you see so many head coaches have one guy that the other coaches go to. And then that guy transfers the information on to the head guy. He can listen to the one voice. Listening to three or four at a time can be confusing at times. I think Jason's done a great job of sorting that out. He knows where he's turning, where he's going to listen. And I think, obviously, what's taken place has helped their preparation for the games become much easier, because now he knows what he's getting into when he gets into each one of these game prep situations.
Talking to Mike Fratello, of course, from the Yes Network, calls the games for the Brooklyn Nets. Can they catch the Raptors?
I think they can. I mean, it's possible. You know, Toronto's been in a lot of close games this year. You know, at home, they're only 17-12. It's not like they have a great record at home, but where they've really done their work is on the road. You know, being 16-14 on the road is sensational for Toronto. But like I said, they've won a lot of close games. So you get one of these three or four game stretches where you don't get the shot at the buzzer, you don't make free throws one night, you hit a team that's hot one night, and one of those things can happen to them, and then it's up to Brooklyn to be able to capitalize and make up ground when they have the opportunity. Three games in the loss column is not that much, you know, with about 25 games, 26 games remaining.
Now, Mike, one thing that Jason's done, he really has limited the minutes of Kevin Garnett, who's missed a couple of games with the back spasms. I think he averages 21 minutes a game. Do you believe that when the Nets get to the playoffs, that he could summon up the old Kevin Garnett? Is that still in him? Is that still in Paul Pierce? Do they have one more lengthy run in them?
When you say summon up that one more run, that depends how many minutes you want it to go up to. Can Kevin contribute more than 21 a night? Yeah, he can, because remember, in the playoffs, you're not going to be playing back-to-back. You'll
right.
have, you know, time off in between. So he has some time for the body to recuperate. That adrenaline is flowing, and he certainly would be able to. If he had to bring it up another 5-6 minutes in playoffs, he can do that. Pierce, I think, is there now as far as his body and feeling his legs and feeling real good about himself. So, yeah, Paul's minutes could be a little bit more. But, you know, I mean, these aren't guys you're counting on to play 42 minutes in a playoff game. And it's not going to happen that way. If you do, you may not have them for the rest of the playoffs.
Who's your biggest surprise on this roster, Mike?
And I'm happy about this. Sean Livingston, rather, has done a terrific job. I'm so happy for him as an individual coming back from, you know, what he came back from. The fact that they play Livingston in the backcourt with Williams gets Deron off the ball occasionally. It allows Livingston to handle. He's long. You can post him up. He gets on the boards for him and gets him some rebounds. And to come back from, you know, so much adversity that he had to face, and there's so many times people said, he's just not going to make it back. Or you always heard people say, God, if you had only seen him when he was really athletic and can do more stuff. Well, he's kind of like back there now. It's taken him a while. But that's what happened when you have a traumatic injury like he had. But he's one of the surprises. You know, I think everybody was waiting for Kirilenko to get to the point where he could play. But we've all known that this is a quality guy. He's a great competitor. He loves winning. He finds ways, whether it's a steal, a block shot, an offensive rebound. You don't have to run a lot of plays for him. He doesn't need a lot of shots. He's just one of those pieces that can really help the team win.